on it to portray him, and there would be no sort of objection. They're not producers on the film. They don't have, you know, say in how they're portrayed. And it was, I think, really a credit to them that they were willing to sort of trust us with that. But Mary and Dan came down and visited, but there was never sort of a, what do you think about this? Is this, you know, we would check in with them about accuracy in terms of the feel of it, because that was really important to me, is the feel of what that newsroom is, the feel of what those meetings were like, and how people were acting. But in terms of their own portrayal, they didn't have any say in it.
And what was the phrase you used for fair use with CBS? So I'm guessing you did not have a lot of contact with CBS.
We didn't have a lot of contact with CBS. I mean, you know, we assumed that, I think correctly, that they weren't going to be thrilled about the fact that this story was going to be told. This was, even from Mary and Dan's point of view, this was not the most proud point in their careers and in their lives. You know, Mary wrote the book, I think, in a lot of ways as sort of a cathartic experience to just kind of deal with what happens and get it out. So, you know, it was, you know, we felt it was an important story that said a lot about the state of journalism and media and how it's evolved and changed over time, even between the time that this happened in 2004 and today. I think it's changed even more. So, it was not something that anyone was sort of racing to the door to say, please tell this story. I mean, we really, and Jamie really had to, you know, convince everyone that this was something that would be meaningful to tell.
Now, when you were on the set, I mean, because there were a lot of Australian crew members, did they know this story? Did they ask you about it?
Because I'm first.
Well,
that's been something that's really interesting about, I imagine more because they read the script, but promoting this, I was doing a film in England, so I did a bunch of promotion for this in England, and they don't really know who Dan Rather is. Mm-hmm. I mean, they know a little bit, but he's not their anchorman, and what I realized is that actually has you see the film in kind of a different way, I think, is that people realize what it says about journalism more easily, you know, which is, to me, that great film, that great speech that Bob makes as Dan at the end of the film, where he kind of says what news used to be and then what it is today. And you realize this is just a guy whose career has spanned from where it started to, I mean, I think when we were at that dinner, he said, you know, when I took over for Walter Cronkite, I went, whoa, what?
Yeah.
But that's, like, I mean, so it's from where we were with Cronkite to,
yeah,
where we are now, whatever that is.
And when you first read the script, did you do a lot of homework on because I think a lot of people kind of vaguely remember Memo Gate or Rather Gate, but I don't know if they know the details.